King apparently recorded this song originally just to fill in a bit of spare studio time. It's amazing how often such songs become classics. The song was a hit when it was first released in 1961, and then in 1986 it got another sort of boost when there was a film made by the same name, Stand By Me, a big film featuring Kiefer Sutherland, Richard Dreyfuss, River Phoenix. It's a fun film to watch. And then more recently, you may also have heard this song on the soundtrack of a Levi jeans ad. So the original recording of this song is in the key of A, but that's a slightly hard key to play, and it involves using bar chords, which we don't want to do at this stage really for this easy guitar section. We're going to stick to using open chords. So we're going to drop it down to the key of G. If you then do want to play it along with a record, that can be done by getting a capo and sticking that on at the second fret and then playing the G chord there and the other chords around the same area. Actually playing it in G I find easier to sing because Benny King's got quite a high voice. Alright, so the first chord we want is the G chord. So we just want the bog standard G chord for this. First finger on the 5th string at the 2nd fret, 2nd finger on the bottom E string at the 3rd fret, and your 3rd finger top E string also at the 3rd fret. Then we've got an E minor. This is a nice easy chord, first finger on the 5th string at the 2nd fret, 2nd finger just beneath it on the D string at the 2nd fret. Then we've got C. So for the C, first finger on the 2nd string, 1st fret, 2nd finger on the 4th string at the 2nd fret, 3rd finger reaching all the way up here to the 3rd fret on the 5th string. Some people that's going to be a bit of a stretch, and you can put that chord down in the other direction. Sometimes it helps to start there. Oops. Put it down that way round instead of that way round. Okay, and then finally we've got the chord D7th. D7th. Again, we put the first finger down on the 2nd string at the 1st fret, 2nd finger on the 3rd string at the 2nd fret, 3rd finger on the 1st string at the 2nd fret. If you've already learnt your D major chord, you can think of D7th as being a sort of mirror image of that, with a triangle pointing the other way. Okay. By the way, you can equally easily use the D chord instead of the D7th chord for this song, and you'll often see it written out that way. In many musical situations, D and D7th are going to be pretty much interchangeable, and this is one of them. The reason for me selecting D7th is simply because it's easier to change to from the C, as one of your fingers is already in the right place. Okay, so once you know each of these chords, spend a little bit of time just shifting from one to the next in order, without worrying about timing or anything else, just get used to the changes. Okay. Okay, so once you've just got used to those different shapes and you know them all well, it's time to look at the actual chord sequence. Notice it starts off with 2 bars of G, then 2 bars of E minor, but only 1 of C and only 1 bar of D7th before coming back to 2 bars of G. It then repeats, and you've got to look out for that because you end on 2 bars of G and then you start the sequence again on 2 more bars of G. So I'm just going to map that sequence out, strumming once per bar to a count of 4, and see if you can follow along with me like that, just to kind of get the feel for the whole thing. All right, after four, one, two, three, four, G, two, three, and again, G, change to E minor again, change to C, D seventh, back to G, stay on G, that's finished the first run, and then we go back to G again for the start of the next one. Minor and again C for one bar straight to D seventh, think ahead and back to G and another G to finish and then two more G's to start again and so on. One of the nice things about this song is the same sequence repeats through verse and chorus. So once we've learnt this 8-bar sequence, that's all there is to learn. Okay, so on to the strumming pattern. This strumming pattern, especially for beginners, can be quite tricky. So we're going to build it up a layer at a time, and this will also give you a little bit of insight into how strumming patterns in general work. Now to begin with, we need to establish a straight 8 pattern. That looks like this. Although this is in 4-4 time, we're going to include half beats. So that's how we get our 8 beat feel. So unusually, we're going to get these 8 beats all with downstrokes. And you'll see that the symbol just underneath the numbers there, that funny little shape, that means downstroke. The beats are shown with the diagonal slashes and the count by the numbers 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and for each bar. That's how we think of it. So this looks like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1. Notice a slightly stronger first beat to each bar. That just helps you keep track of where you are. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. Once you've practiced that enough to get it nice and relaxed and nice and smooth, try imposing the chord sequence on that pattern like this. So we establish the strumming pattern. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1. Now I'm going to count in, and then we start the G chord. 1, 2, 3, 4, G. E minor, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, and C. 2, 3, D7, 2, 3, and back to G. And again G. Start again, G, 2, 3, 4, and G, 2, 3, and change E minor, 2, 3, 4, C, 2, straight to D7, back to G. Okay, so once you've got that down smoothly, and it may take a few hours to get that, then we're going to add one more accented beat, and this comes on the and beat after the two. That looks like this. Notice that the fourth diagonal slash is in bold, meaning that we emphasize this beat. Because we tend to do this by making the hand travel further to include more strings, for most people learning this song, you will need to miss the next beat to give your hand time to travel back again. That is why the third beat is in brackets. That simply means don't contact the string on this beat. Let's show you what I mean. So we've started out with our 8-beat downstrokes like 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. And now we're going to add in another emphasized beat, 1 and 2 and. And then you'll find it's hard to get back, so we're going to miss the next beat. We're going to go 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3. May take a bit of practice, but have a crack at getting that nailed and then see if you can superimpose the chords over it. Now that's a perfectly workable strumming pattern for this song, and feel free to go ahead and stick the chords over that and use that for a while. But for perfectionists, it's good to work towards putting that missing beat back in, to really get the thing sounding as close to how it sounds on the record as you can. So that looks like this. So we started with our 8 beats, 1 and 2 and 3 and 4, and we then emphasised that and beat after the 2, 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. And we just keep that hand going afterwards, 1 and 2. Try it again. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. So that's where we're headed. Okay, now it's performance time. So do play along with me on this. And whatever level you've got it to, whether you're strumming just one strum per bar or you've got any one of these kind of interim steps down with the accented offbeat as well, that's great. Just let your hand flow along with it. Now I'm going to try singing this song just to give you some kind of guide, but please bear in mind Benny King's a great singer and you're soon going to realise why I teach guitar and not vocals. All right. So let's play out with this now, and I'll see you again in the next lesson. 1, 2, 3, 4. Just as long as you stand by me. So darling, darling, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. Stand by me. Stand by me. If the sky that we look upon should tumble and fall, and a mountain crumble to the sea, I won't cry, I won't cry, oh I won't shed a tear, just as long as you stand.